Remember our grand plan for calculating difficult derivatives? It had two ingredients: knowing the derivatives of standard functions and knowing some rules of calculation. In these videos, we will tackle the derivatives of some standard functions. We will use the derivative of the exponential function to calculate the derivatives of x to the power p. The trick we will use here applies to any ugly function involving exponentials, so you can use it too. Let us recall the definition of the derivative as the limit of a difference quotient. While the idea is not to use this formula in actual calculations and use standard derivatives and rules of calculation instead, we have to use it to calculate the derivative of our standard functions. Let us first consider exponential functions. We plug an exponential function, f of x equals a to the power x, in the formula for the difference quotient. This gives a to the x plus delta x minus a to the x over delta x. But the rules of calculation for an exponential show that this also equals a to the power x times a to the delta x minus a to the x over delta x. Taking a to the x apart, we find that this equals a to the x times a to the delta x minus 1 over delta x. Notice that the right part is exactly the difference quotient for a to the x at 0. Taking the limit as delta x goes to 0, we see that the derivative of a to the x at x equals a to the x times the derivative at 0, a constant times a to the x. This constant depends on a. Looking at the graphs of different exponential functions, we see that the derivative at 0 is very small and positive if a is slightly more than 1, whereas we can make it as large as we want by increasing a. At some point, the constant will be equal to 1, so the graph will be tangent to y equals x plus 1. The corresponding value of a is called e. The value of e equals 2.718, etc. So in fact, the derivative of the standard function e to the x is e to the x by definition. For a to the x, for other values of a, we now use that a to the x equals e to the x ln a and use the chain rule. The x ln a. This gives that it's equal to the derivative of e to the x at x ln a times the derivative of x ln a, which is equal to a to the x times ln a. Let us now consider the derivative of ln x. Ln x is the inverse function of e to the x, and we can obtain its derivative by considering the equation x equals e to the ln x. The derivative of x equals 1, thus that is the result of applying the chain rule to the right-hand side. So 1 equals the derivative of e to the ln x equals the derivative of e to the x at ln x times the derivative of ln x. As e to the ln x equals x, this gives 1 equals x times the derivative of ln x, so that we find that the derivative ln x equals 1 over x. The trick of using the exponential function to calculate derivatives of a function involving exponents can also be used if the x dependence is in the base. Thus we find that the derivative of x to the power p for arbitrary p, not just integers, can be calculated by writing x to the p equals e to the p ln x. Using the chain rule, we obtain that the derivative of x to the p equals the derivative of e to the x at p ln x times the derivative of p ln x, which equals e to the p ln x times p over x, which is x to the p times p over x equals p times x to the p minus 1. These calculations so show that you don't have to remember all standard derivatives, as you can derive some from others. However, we use the derivative of x to the p often enough that it is easier to just remember that it is multiplied by exponent and decrease exponent by 1, than to remember its derivation. However, if you're like me and often forget whether the derivative of 2 to the x is 2 to the x times ln 2 or 2 to the x divided by ln 2, you can always fall back to remembering this derivation to get it right. Now, try to use the trick to rewrite complicated exponentials as e to the something to calculate some derivatives yourself.